Welcome to video on high voltage engineering for BE 7th semester electrical engineering. In this video, we are going to consider unit 4, generation of high voltages and currents. In this, the second topic is generation of high voltage DC using full wave rectifier circuit. The learning objectives for this particular topic is to understand how to generate high voltage DC using full wave rectifier, what are the constraints on circuit design, and effect of ripple voltage on DC output. Having already studied the half-wave rectifier circuit in the earlier video, let us move ahead with the second method of generating high DC voltage using full-wave rectifier. This slide shows the circuit diagram for full wave rectifier using center tapped secondary high voltage transformer. Two rectifier elements are involved, rectifier A and rectifier B. The operation is fairly simple. During positive half cycle, rectifier A is forward biased and rectifier B is reverse biased. Kindly pay attention to the animation visible on the circuit diagram to understand the operation better. So let us highlight the polarity. For positive half cycle, the upper terminal of transformer secondary is at positive potential with respect to the lower terminal. We can see rectifier A is indicated with a green color, indicating that it is forward biased, while rectifier B is indicated with a red color, indicating that it is reverse biased. During this condition, the current will flow in a manner indicated from transformer secondary through rectifier A, load resistance RL, and back to the center tap. So please observe the animation for current flow as visible here. So current originates from the upper terminal of transformer secondary and terminates on the center tap winding terminal. The capacitor connected across load charges through rectifier A as shown in the diagram. So this way, during positive half cycle, the capacitor charges and output voltage is available across the load corresponding to the upper section of transformer secondary. Now let us move ahead with the negative half cycle of supply. So polarity reversal will take place and rectifier B will be forward biased and rectifier A is reverse biased. Again, pay attention to the animation shown on the diagram. It shows that the lower terminal is now positive. Consequently, rectifier B is forward biased and rectifier A is reverse biased. Next, we are going to show how the current flows through the circuit during negative half cycle. So please pay attention to the flow of current. It will flow through rectifier B, then to the load RL and back to the center tap. and capacitor charges this time through rectifier B as shown by this flow in the diagram. So this way a full wave rectifier provides a rectified high DC voltage across load terminal. Let us move ahead and check with the full wave rectifier waveforms. The waveform consists of two voltages. Upper voltage is a secondary terminal voltage of high voltage transformer. It shows the voltage across one of the sections of the transformer with respect to center tap, while the lower waveform indicates output voltage without filter capacitor and with filter capacitor. So let us first go through the animation to understand the nature of waveform without a capacitor filter connected across the load. So this waveform in the output will be shown in red color. Let us check with the output waveform. Positive half cycle, rectifier A conducts. During negative half cycle, rectifier B conducts. So we get a full wave rectified pulsating voltage across the output terminal. For practical purposes, this waveform needs to be ripple free, or at least with minimum ripple voltage. That's why when capacitor is connected across the load terminal of suitable value, then the nature of output waveform will get modified as shown from the next animation that overlaps on this waveform diagram. So we can see that during the discharge, the capacitor voltage is falling by a very small amount, and consequently the nature of output voltage is almost constant. So this way a full wave rectified constant DC voltage may be obtained with proper design of capacitor filter. Let us note down the highlights of this operation as shown on the waveform. During positive half cycle, the capacitor charges through rectifier A, while rectifier B is reverse biased. In the negative half cycle, the capacitor charges through rectifier B, while rectifier A is reverse biased. Hence, full wave rectified output voltage is obtained. The source transformer requires a center tap secondary with peak voltage rating of twice Vmax. The capacitor value is chosen such that output voltage DC is having minimum ripple content. So the condition that must be satisfied is that time constant RL and C, RL multiplied by C, is at least 10 times the time period of AC supply. Each of the rectifier valve must have a peak inverse voltage, that is PIV, of at least twice Vmax. This is the voltage that appears across individual rectifier when it is in the reverse bias condition. Let us refer to further circuit details. Now, this part of the details are common and special feature of high voltage rectifier circuits, which were also covered and explained during the half wave rectifier. So we will go through this section quickly. sixth point is for DC voltages of 50 kV and higher, electron tube rectifier valve have special construction due to the high electrostatic field. During the non-conduction period, this is the seventh point, the heater filament and cathode experience mechanical forces due to field gradient. Anode is firmly fixed to the wall cover on one side. Cathode and heater filaments are covered with protective grid made of steel mesh maintained at cathode potential on the other end of the wall. A single electron tube of peak inverse voltage 250 kV is available for use in such applications. Let us move to the next slide. Further, in modern high voltage laboratories, semiconductor rectifier using silicon diodes are used, having peak inverse voltage of 1 kV to 2 kV. So individual diodes have a rating of up to 2 kV or even higher as development is going on. But for higher voltages, several silicon diodes may be connected in series along with the voltage grading circuits. For high voltage generation, selenium stacks of maximum peak inverse voltage of 500 kV are useful with don't require voltage grading capacitors. Let us move to the next slide and understand the ripple voltage part of full wave rectifier. The output voltage contains ripple and DC output voltage is less than the maximum AC input voltage due to the presence of ripple contents. The ripple frequency in case of full wave rectifier is twice the input supply frequency, and percentage ripple is less as compared to the half wave rectifier circuit. Let us have comparison of waveforms of half wave and full wave rectifier circuits. We can clearly observe that for the same input AC voltage, the output available from half wave rectifier is a single pulse output for one cycle of AC input voltage, while for a full wave rectifier it's a two pulse output, and higher the pulse number, better is the quality of waveform, because the average value of DC voltage is double as compared to the earlier case. So with this particular discussion, in this particular video, we have understood how to generate high DC voltages using a full wave rectifier with specific focus on use of center tapped high voltage transformer. If you have any queries, then you can post it on forum. Thanks.